This is an ABC podcast.
This is The Conversation Hour with Rochelle Hunt and Warwick Long on ABC Radio Melbourne and Victoria.
And today, Warwick Long, as students, probably most of them skipped off to school as you waved goodbye to them at the front gate of their schools. There are actually other students today that we are going to talk about on the Conversation Hour, and that is our international students. Now, our international students here in Victoria have been hugely affected by coronavirus. There's been no financial assistance. Many have lost their part-time work. There's been no access to their campus, and many have lost their accommodation as well. But Warwick, when we think about international students in this state, I dare say that most of us think about the economic impact that they have on our economy, the money that they bring to our state. So today we're going to look at what else do international students bring other than their cash.
To the Conversation Hour, as we look at international students, what they bring to our country and also how are they being treated and what are they going through right now. 1300 222 774 if you'd like to join us.
Ritesh Chugh is Indian Australian and is a part of CQ University as well. He graduated, he's also a senior lecturer now and is a huge part of our community. Ritesh, welcome to the Conversation Hour. What made you not only come and study in Victoria but then decide to stay and be such a big part of our community?
Good morning, Rochelle and Warwick. Thank you for having me. Coming to Australia was a significant decision of my life and actually a life-changing one. I've now nearly spent half of my life in Australia. And my decision was based on the quality of education, safe surroundings, lack of pollution, job opportunities and medical facilities that Australia offers. Now, educational agents overseas play a very important role in shaping our choice when we're deciding on where to study as an international student. And I don't think it was any different to me. What was different to me, though, was I had a school-time friend who influenced my choice of Melbourne. So there was no debate of Melbourne versus Sydney. And now that I know coffee is better here, I know I made the right choice.
And Ritesh, I know you're highly involved within your local school as well at the moment, and you're trying to introduce Hindi language into primary schools to, I guess, help diversity and inclusion. I mean, you've had a badge of a Lay Law Hero Community Volunteer Award. When we talk about diversity and inclusion, and given how long you've been in Australia now, are we starting to make inroads, do you think?
We are, but see, the issues, some of the issues still remain. I have a lot of respect for international students, but having said that, one of the things that I feel, you know, we need to realize that international education in Melbourne enriches both domestic and international students. It prepares all students for a competitive global workforce where cultures and countries are connected, and they're connecting more rapidly than ever before. And, you know, if I talk about my own experience here, you know, I mean, I got my job through initially networking. So I started with a casual tutoring role, which I enjoyed. This led me to a love for teaching. I completed my PhD. To answer your question, do the issues exist? Well, I definitely feel they exist. You know, language barriers and cultural differences always exist. And it's up to the students to realize how they want to make best of the opportunities. You know, it's very important that students focus on developing careers and think of long-term goals, you know, rather than focusing on short-term goals. Once they understand the value of money, they focus on their studies. And I mean, if I talk of myself, you know, when I was studying, I actually set myself very high targets for achieving high grades. I mean, I really remember having a conversation with my dean at that time when I just finished my graduate diploma of information systems, and I said to her, I said, well, I'm going to set a target for myself and try and achieve 8 high distinctions to finish my master's. So that was the sort of goal setting that I did. But, you know, the problems exist. To develop as an international student, I think it's important for students to work on their communication and interpersonal skills. That is one of the most important things that I believe can help international students succeed. You know, technical skills can actually be learned on the job. But what employers are looking for is communication and interpersonal skills.
It's really good advice. Yeah. Ritesh, thank you so much for joining us. Ritesh Chugh, Indian-Australian, a huge part of his local community was trying to introduce Hindi language to his local primary school. He's been given awards. He's the Laylaw local community hero there. And we can start to see why, given the advice that he's given to us. You are on The Conversation now. We've been talking international